So, hip hop and jazz are going out the similar experiences.
You walk out in the street and ask a young black man if he trusts the president.
That family life.
So much about the
well, people started dying around us.
Heroin becomes an anesthetizer.
Do you trust the person who raped your grandmother?
I don't deal with churches.
We've been fucked over so many times.
It's wiping people out.
Shit gets critical sometimes.
The person who made us slaves is still in charge.
And y'all say niggas are scared of revolution?
I want to be here to see my daughter turn 18.
Another dimension to the social misery.
Jazz brings to hip hop a spiritual plane.
The black people are dying.
It's an international killer.
They're in for a big surprise if they don't think this can happen to them.
This is genocide. We have to wake up.
What does jazz bring to hip hop? Hip-hop is a form of music that embraces all the forms of music that have come before it, which includes jazz, reggae, rock and roll, funk, R&B, etc. So it brings everything to hip-hop, and then hip-hop brings a lot back. It's a give and take thing.
Jazz brings to hip-hop a spiritual plane. I think that's where the jazz musicians of yesterday, that's the mind state that they were at, and that's where hip-hop is now.
Each rapper has a different perspective. We're all like different pieces to a puzzle. Chuck D calls rap urban CNN. So we're all just kicking in different things that have to do with the whole picture of what's going on with the youth today. And that's what rap is a voice of. And if you try to stifle that or censor that, then you're going to lose the true essence of what's going on, and which is the mirror of society. And people always say that the youth is the future, so they need to take heed. Dr. Byrd says that rap music and the music of today is a safety valve for society, meaning that if there wasn't this music to perform or to listen to, then people would take their tensions out other ways, and there'd be more than just one L.A. riot.
In hip-hop, you have a variety of different voices. You have some progressive voices. You have some voices that are relatively indifferent to the issue, highlighting other issues. And you have some voices that are downright retrograde and reactionary, that reinforce the same homophobic stereotypes, the same misogynist stereotypes. But it's important to highlight the diversity. And I think it's a challenge to young artists in hip-hop culture to represent the best of the black freedom struggle, which is to stay in contact with the humanity of every member of the black community, which allows you to stay in contact with the humanity of each and every member of the human family. And that means enforce calling into question homophobia, calling into question misogyny and patriarchal sensibilities, calling into question class arrogance, and calling into question the sense of feeling that somehow, by reproducing the same kind of stereotypes, that one is powerful, that one can pose and posture in the same form of power that is being used against one.
No, people of color aren't heeding the message because, so-called people of color in the United States especially have been trained to not even look for the message. And the message isn't ever directed towards them because, you know, we are people who this country hasn't cared about since they forced us to come over here. So, no, we're not heeding the message. We don't even understand how important the message is if we hear it.
Nobody gives a damn about the government in the inner city where I come from. They think that that's the enemy. And that's really how they feel. So they're like, whatever. And so I can go out. I'm going out like a G. My community would be represented by the hip-hop society. So in the hip-hop society, yeah, there's awareness. But I don't know. People aren't heeding to the words because they think it's not possible. They think it's just some stuff they see on TV, a gang of like homosexuals or like AIDS victims. I can't say AIDS victims. I gotta say,
my name is Mr. Rubber, and what I want you to do is roll me on, please. So everybody in the house, if you down with doing something about this disease, let me hear you say, hell yeah. Yeah, yeah, and it goes a little like this. We are the far side, if you didn't know. My man Slim Kid Trey and my man Booty Brown getting down with this band like this, yo. And we gonna do it like this. And it goes, a check, 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 check it out. I dig the loose sweat, woman, true shit. Though my brain doesn't calculate the fate. Sliding through the secret gardens, I beg the pardon regardless the odds with my snake. He's such a sinner. And every willow goddess is marked as a winner. Digging in the holes of the soul like a tenor sax. And baby got backs, crack up in the throw and in this. Yo, I can't hold it back in the darkness. Been playing like me won't get caught in. Every day me be out there stalking. But pay attention when you're hawking and marking. Territories never glory for to see the dolphin. Caught in the tuna net. Cause you will get the bird's eye triple high news to the neck. Yo, who's ready to go? When Slim brings grim to the show. You better stop.
Think about it.
Yo, check it out. The beauty of the booty got me in a trance. In my pants I was squirming like Pee Wee Herman from a single table dance. But she knows IVs, no Pee Wees, cause I bees. Kinging like Kong cause my ding-a-ling's long. With my ding-dong I make crotches sing songs. Make the guts sing praise and I'll pace for the doom. The day I go sliding, bare in a room in a blood-hot greasy slide. Without my unraveling whatnot. What I got is a plan and a plot. Already got the crotch, hopping like scotch. Ready, hot and willing, but I know the penicillin ain't killing this public enemy.
What so it's been to me?
Doomsday for the EF, I flip. Gotta get a grip, grip, cause blood be dripping when I'm whipping asses like cream. You know what I mean? I try to comply with the game plan. Don't ask me why. I pry up in the thigh and just do it, and just do it. You better and think about it. You better stop.
With my heart in my neck, oh heck, what have I done? I throw my cards on the damn table, but just one night of fun. I wish it wasn't cable, was the second round of town that we found in the town with
last week.
Yeah, needless to speak, I find the physique that caught my eye. I woke up next morning, blood naked and high. On life, not my wife, like a knife I stabbed. Placed them on the table till I did not grab. Now with the frown I stare and a gown I wear into the light, praying that the overnight passion will not catch this ass. I'm asking God, it won't be odd, cause the ass before just right then the doctor into the door.
Yo, yo, I want all y'all to just sing this with me. And it goes like this. You better stop
and think about it.
And think about it.
You better stop and think about it.
You better stop
and think about it.
You better stop
and think about it.
Let's check it out.
Dreamed of growing up and being somebody, and this disease tells me over and over again that it's gonna kill me before it lets me grow old.
People in this society, I think maybe all over the world, have to realize that there are systematic plans that have been devised to almost destroy certain kinds of people. Black people, creative people, artistic people.
I didn't do any wrong. I love myself today, and I affirm that. I love my feet, I love my eyes, I love my nose. You know, I love my body. I'm not a walking disease.
Chercher de sérum, l'homme est comme un ange en danger, que les eaux du Gange veulent changer. La thune de ce morceau aura pour utilité d'aider de Tanger à Angers, un ange en danger. Cher, yeah, the voice of the passé.
Le sida dans ta peau, et tu n'aimes pas le charbon, tu ne veux pas lui échapper, tu restes sur le capot. Le sida dans ta peau, et tu n'aimes pas le charbon, tu ne veux pas lui échapper, tu restes sur le capot.
Je me dois d'être courtois, tu te demandes pourquoi. Que la cause est noble, voilà. C'est grâce à l'héritage jazz que l'homme singe devient l'homme sage. J'ai l'âge de 10 ans quand je demande à ma maman pourquoi tant de mal dans le monde des grands. C'était cool à l'époque avec mon short et mes bottes. Désormais quand je suis grand je pense au spot sur les capotes. J'espère que les choses vont changer. Yeah, un ange est en danger. C'est un pacemaker. Hip hop non-stop, du jazz, panaz. Live, pas samplé dans un disque d'occasion. Nous avons fait notre part. Le ciel peut juger pour tenter de sauver un ange en danger. Un ange en danger. Un ange en danger. Un ange en danger.
Say to my brothers and sisters that I know it's hard to understand and it's real deep, but if we don't protect ourselves and use safe sex, we're just killing each other. You know, this is genocide. We have to wake up.
Within the African American community and the Hispanic community is denial because they feel that that can't happen to them, that it won't happen to them.
People are still in denial. A lot of people are spreading the virus with knowledge of the fact that they are infected because they feel that they have to get back at the person who gave it to them. They go through the question of why me? And my only advice to them is that why not you? You are not special. All of us are going through something.
People are in denial because they're trying to deal with the other issues, you know, that HIV just impacts on. The lack of jobs, the lack of decent housing, the lack of adequate health care, and then there's HIV to boot. Just the conditions under which we live every day and the stress of everyday life here, you know, in our community is leading to the progression of AIDS and death for us.
I think the denial has to do with, on the one hand, feeling as if there could not be another dimension to the social misery. There's already enough social misery in the black community. Here comes another layer. And trying to hold that at arm's length and feel as if it couldn't be, but we had to come to terms with the facts. Growing all the time in chocolate cities.
Because to be poor, and we can't do nothing about it. As long as you have no money to get something to pay for this, you're not gonna get it. Yeah, I believe they feel that black people deserves what they're getting. That's why they don't tell you much about nothing. They kept it to themselves. If I thought it was this bad, I would be more careful. It's a terrible letdown.
I went to school where promiscuity and a lot of people were coming to terms with their sexuality, the diversity of their sexuality. Out of six of us that used to hang together, there's only two of us left.
Yo, let me fuck your mind. Soul in the nocturnal sunshine. Let me kiss your mind, yeah. Bathe your soul in the nocturnal sunshine. Yeah, if you let me, I'll tease you. Enchanted by one emotionally satisfying kiss. Trust is just a necessary hang up, ain't that right, baby? Warm ovations exist between your thighs, Marvin Gaye. Black butterfly, salvation of my blue-black soul is realized. I said your mind calls out with a horse in the bait shop. Come in and let me fuck that mind. Let me kiss your mind. Bathe your soul in the nocturnal sunshine. Come here, let me kiss your mind. Bathe that soul in the nocturnal sunshine. You know what love is? Take me back to the red velvet furniture, the shag carpet, and you beneath me in a mad bath, like Superfly, the end Wonder dreams the world in the nocturnal sunshine. I'm begging you to enter me. Your mind makes the river ease. Come here and walk slowly inside me. Check it out, let me kiss your mind. Bathe your soul in the nocturnal sunshine. Cause ain't nothing wrong with a little bit of bump and grind. Let me kiss your mind. Bathe your soul in the nocturnal sunshine.
Because of in the heat of the moment, sometimes they're out of reach, and you just want to get a nut as soon as possible. And the feeling is just totally different. They're on total different scales.
Nah, you can't hit it the same. I know why people don't use rubbers, because they feel whack. But until recently, magnums for black people. But before then, AIDS was just jacking people up because rubbers were so whack and nobody wanted to use them. It was like, whatever. I wanted to feel the skin. Yeah. That's how it was really going down. People were really not giving a damn.
They was like, I don't care.
No, they say
the government makes the rubbers and the condoms, and if you don't trust the government, why in the world would you use something that they're giving you and saying, you know what I'm saying, that could be helping it to spread. That's what people are thinking, because they don't really know. They can just go on what's the government saying, and nobody gives a damn about the government in the inner city where I come from. They think that that's the enemy.
Better care of myself today.
To be cut. Responsibility.
Just what I have to do to stay alive.
They keep us in a place, the government, the media, they keep us thinking certain things. In the meantime, we're losing generations of people.
I really kind of think that it's a design to keep us dying as opposed to help us perpetuate our lives.
Another dimension to the social misery.
A corrupt.
Damn! By the man.
It's all about the history of this country.
Hey, yo, come on, what's going on? Levels of the Black Fort interfering with your program.
Design.
Man-made.
The media.
Damn.
They want to always, you know, put prices on this and prices on that because it's about money out here.
I am Mr. Black Thought, my height 5'7", caramel a better chocolate complexion.
I think it has something to do with the New World Order, has something to do with AIDS, has something to do with the space program. All that is, I think, is intertwined.
Relentless self-critique.
Slave master's not going to do anything for you. He's not going to educate you. He's not going to keep you or nothing. What you expect? That's where we are today. Would you trust the person who raped your grandmother? What would be your answer? We're not supposed to be out of slavery, so putting out a message about AIDS awareness is not going to come into the ghetto. That's the last thing the government wants to do.
They don't want to cure the disease. That's what it is. They got it. They made it. It's man-made.
Just the conditions under which we live every day and the stress.
And never trust the white man, and that's the truth. They want to help you first. And then they fuck you. And then, when you try to trust them, they fuck you again.
What's going on?
That's the plan. Don't you see? It's happening right before our eyes.
Proceed.
Fit into one another. But they're faking it like, okay, yeah, we're going to go do this space mission. That's some bullshit. We're going to go do this research. That's some bullshit. All that, I think, is one big program, and each one is, like, connecting, and it's going to be a big picture at the end. We're going to be like, damn, we was just sitting back and getting played by the man.
Think, just think, what if you could just blink, what, blink yourself away?
Let's get it right. We're slaves in this country. The only reason we are here is slavery.
To say the word conspiracy 400 years later is not even dealing with the problem.
The effects and consequences could lead one to think that there's a conspiracy because they are that bad. At the same time, the conspiracy is a cry of urgency for the situation. Whether there's actually a conspiracy, I don't think so. But ultimately, that is not the issue, because to say there's not a conspiracy can reinforce complacency. But the sense of urgency is real, and the effects and consequences are overwhelming, and therefore we all ought to be standing at the edge of the abyss and crying out, we've got to do something. The claim that there's a conspiracy is a certain cry out that we've got to do something because it is overwhelming. I resonate with that side of what they're saying. But I don't believe there's a conspiracy per se. I think there's a host of elites who simply give it a low priority, and that's what makes me upset.
Let's get back on track.
Into my bleeding mind as it cries for the strength to repel the sanctimonious sounds of the white rock group, the Grateful Dead, are the black and Latino women who are 85% of the AIDS cases in New York City are being choked by the Christianity gas passed by the most reverend Bishop Gordon J. Shane as he shocks into us, oh, in the name of the Lord now, and my realities have turned into a stone figuration of Miss Liberty as she stands on the corners of the world, as she stands on the corners selling her HIV infected self to the world, to anyone who doesn't use condoms, and all the while, he sits on a throne of ego shit with DDT in one hand and wearing a crown of black and Latino children who are 87% of the AIDS cases at New York City, and I watch him relax by playing golf with Roy Wilkins' balls, with Maynard Rustin glued to his thing, while Xerox copies of Martin Luther King are popping from his skull to dream the impossible dream. Knock, knock, who's there? It's Red Brown, and if you don't open up, I'll strike it out and burn your house down, and I see Malcolm's spirit, his eyes burning red, black, and green flames, and crying tears of Thunderbird wine that seem to touch my lips and make me become 31 types of freedom! Freedom by any means necessary. It's necessary to have freedom by any means necessary. And I begin to hate with love and love with hate. This is madness! This is madness! This is madness! I look up and see the moon, and I look up and see the moon bleeding lifeless white maggots and screaming for my help as the eagle's ripping claws rip and tear at his virginal form. Oh, EC's, oh, Duke Moses, oh, Sunma, oh, Allah, Bismillah, and Abmanarim, give me your undying strength to rise up and reorder the cosmos so that man can truly understand and appreciate the cosmic beauties and realities of science and love. And he has turned. And he has turned the feminine part of me. And he has turned the feminine part of me into a sexual thing. Look at her standing there wearing a mango miniskirt made from the strands of Freud's mother's pubic hairs and an uncovered breast dripping blood and pus and her lips colored with the anesthetic white woman called a Marietta. She smiles at me through the indignity of Buakana ejaculating sperm into her mind. George Wallace mentally finger fucking you at night in his wet dreams, and a soft wet clinging tears of love seem to flood my heart with strength to gather all my manhood from my lower head and to put it back in my upper head. And I hear my mother's voice, and I hear my mother's voice, and I hear my mother's voice rustling in the wind, reminding me of the many times he tried to rape her of her blackness. But she, with the strength of a panther, the swiftness of a cheetah, and the cunning of a lioness, would not be caged up without the lies that kept me from being totally free. And when she came home at night, I could smell the musty closeness of his body and see his translucent fingerprints on a tired, weary physical structure, depressed from warding off his beastly attacks. But she would smile, the smile of a thousand black orchids in me, not realizing all the while that the anger of 100 liars was residing in my soul. And doing all this time, my father, was somewhere drowning this mutant plastic mind itself in a bottle of cheap wine, and letting that spiritual catalyst, John Coltrane, pay celestial homage to that white god who was riding his How can you be supreme and sing songs of black love when your mouth is overrunning with the sperm of trigger, and when inside when it's going to commit suicide when he finds out that Nat Turner made love to his great-great-grandmother, and he has taken our most violent and militant leaders and stuck lollipops up the ass to pacify their black mothers, and he is beginning to assume that all of us were born under the same colors of war, because all we do is bullshit.
They have to do what I call a 360-degree mind revolution.
Anything that is discomforting, anything that generates discontent, we don't want to deal with.
Be careful, please. This is no joke.
People need to talk about sex in our community.
People are so afraid of homosexuality because they know that they have a little bit of it in them and they don't want to accept that. They want to think that they're exempt from being a lesbian or being homosexual, and that's not true. We all have a little bit of that in us.
You're playing Russian roulette with your life.
Passion is real. And passion can be very good, but we have to be mindful of the consequences.
Well, it's like so much confusion going on. You don't know, you know, which way to really go.
You don't know how many times I have brought syringes out on the street, and these syringes were resealed. Someone had used it before they sold it to me and had blood in them, and me being sick at the moment, I could care less.
People who are using drugs are not using drugs because they're getting high. They're using drugs because they're medicating themselves. Heroin becomes an anesthetizer. You know, cocaine becomes an anesthetic. People are self-medicating because they can't get the proper medication that they need.
Flying high in the Brooklyn sky.
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 I'm been still laying, like I said, under the screen. We your eighth wonder. So for the Nia, I do it. Shit, push a little fist, fit my 120s. Greet the Avenue Blue. Corner flying into a 40, 20 brothers lay in a bottle. 30 fly right by, double time and shit. Extra I'm hitting, so I can step soon up. For the Nova, so know what it goes south. So see my G, yeah, she coming. No, I'm not a flesh vendor. Mecca got soul, living way past Sam. Shot opened on my lip just in time. No, we think I popped it to a leader one cool, cause we flying high in the Brooklyn sky. Flying high
in the Brooklyn sky.
Flying high
in the Brooklyn sky.
Oh, yes, we
flying high in the Brooklyn sky.
Flying high
in the Brooklyn sky.
Flying high
in the Brooklyn sky.
Flying high
in the Brooklyn sky.
Just flying high in the Brooklyn sky.
The wind, so I blow minds. Curb hanger and hop it at the oracle of hipster. Just like Black Caesar, my shit is fresh. Cause you're a fish and I'm a water sign. My laid back pimp walk is linear by design. Gold front soul, a shoddy, now watch him shine. Me and Cino making it upon it. I'm glad to see my nigga so close and lavish. So I wear my shit tilted, cause I got style. Like every nigga at the corner store with brown boots. This is our beats and we do be tripping. Bouncing around the ab like Saturn at high volume. I flash a slick grin saying cool with nuance. The donor eater sweated the blackness we all flaunt. He asked me what's my name, I told him Mark Essex. Sucker, I got lessons forever, I'm about to bless it. So roll, roll as I grind you with my dust. I wander through my mind, select the style of bus. MCs wear the jewelry I drop as fetish links. Then brother butter blast off and smother out the ink. Is it because of high 130 backspin the decks? The down solids are a murder with caviar. Ghetto, the Son and God sequel. I read my manifesto with gusto, presto, and pronto. Deep and sweet on X amount streets I glide. Watson Soledad, Watson 65. I don't need to write no shit to be legit. I go off the top cause it's just really hip hop. A baseball hat and baggy jeans don't make you no cooler than me and my MC power from the old school. Down from the LES, Brooklyn represent, we fresh each and every day. It's like this, we don't play, so I'm saying. AIDS is the disease that I don't wanna catch. So when this, I protect my dick with the condom. I'm on the, just like Genji on the beach now. If you ask me where I'm from, then I'll say each and every day. You won't ask why, yo God, I'm number 7. That's heaven flying high in the Brooklyn sky. Come on, flying high in the Brooklyn sky.
Flying high in the Brooklyn sky. In the Brooklyn skies, flying high in the Brooklyn skies, flying high in the Brooklyn skies.
So,
and here comes the 715 to the 4, taking your mind on a universal tour. I saw the skies with my brother Butterfly. Can't deny we on natural high. Living on the edge is a constant struggle, but with knowledge itself, it takes me to another level of conscious thought. Now the flower child blooms. I was raised as a frop to the substance tomb. I study in Kuma, keep a scowl on my face. No doubt in your mind, I refute time and space. Waste no time on the nigga state of mind. I'm supreme, but it seems the kids don't know the time. So I keep reaching, keep teaching, baby. Living proof of the insect theory. I get swivvy as I cruise New York City. Saying power, equality, our laws is equality, yeah. I'm flying high, so, so high. I'm flying high in the Brooklyn skies. Come on, flying high in the Brooklyn skies. Flying high in the Brooklyn skies. I'm
flying high in the Brooklyn skies.
I am
in the Brooklyn skies.
Flying high. Peace to the nation of gods of earth. Yes, yes, straight from Sector 6, Digable Planets, Massive, Brooklyn.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Lester Bowie, give it up. What you say, baby? For Mr. Joe Sample over here on the rules. Now you can't see him buried over there on the guitar. Ladies and gentlemen, the skillful styles of Mr. Wild Wild Watson. Blow up the spot, son.
And a lot of people are afraid of homosexuality is both merits are very complex and a simple answer. I think Americans have been raised to fear anything that goes against the so-called norm or what is moral. And I think that the misconception of what manhood and womanhood is about is based almost entirely on sex and not love, and I think that has something to do with it, has a lot to do with it.
At first, the media made HIV or AIDS a gay disease, a gay epidemic, a gay cancer, all these different terms, and gay in the black community or in our minority communities is just something that's detrimental to them. They think it's detrimental to their upliftment. We'll be right back.
think that people are afraid of homosexuality because we have been socialized into a way of looking at the world that associates difference with degradation, rather than understanding difference for difference and not using it as a basis of degrading people or creating hierarchies. But we see this across the board. We see it in race, we see it in class, we see it in region, we see it in sexual orientation.
The fear behind the homophobia is that a part of ourselves, we're afraid that we may be that way, that we could be gay. That fear comes from a religious teaching. It comes from religion is something that is put on us as human beings to keep us in a certain place. So is politics, to keep the masses down. So if we're taught that being homosexual is a sin against God, then we have a belief system right there that says, oh, I'm afraid. Now, if my natural tendency is to be gay, if I fall in love with another man, what is wrong with that? Do you think that God looks at that as being blasphemous or dark or black or dirty? I don't think so. I think the love is the key, but we lose sight of that because of fear once again.
The Creator has a master plan. Peace and love in every land. The Creator has a master plan. Peace and love in every land. The Creator has a master plan.
And I myself, quite honestly, I've had very deep homophobic socialization as a brother growing up in the church and on the street. And so I've had to engage in relentless self-critique so I could stay in contact with the humanity of gay brothers like James Baldwin, lesbian sisters like Audre Lorde, and a whole host of nameless and anonymous gay brothers and lesbian sisters. That's an effort on my part because I have to fight the homophobia that has been drilled into me by the larger society.
Paradox now is that I have more meaning and more purpose to life, and life is more precious now that I'm HIV positive.
Yeah, I have hope for another life. I'm not even thinking about this one because it's kind of ruined. But as long as I'm here, I'm just happy with the friends that I have and my family.
Yeah, I think young people do have to recognize that there's a number of traps that the larger society does create. And oftentimes young people feel as if they're forms of rebellion, but these forms of rebellion results often in falling to the very traps that are being laid, you see. And therefore one has to have a much broader view of how one rebels. And one of the ways in which one rebels is to ensure that we reproduce one another. Quality of living, reproduce one another in terms of quality relationships. And we owe it to one another to be honest and candid enough with one another to ensure that we don't infect one another.
Thank you.
Funding for this program was provided by the Corporation for Public Broadcasting.